Mali. The foundation 1787, Una y'all be at? Where y'all be?
Oh, Lord, no.
Y'all them folks from up north?
Oh, they have blessing.
Y'all need to be quiet. I still. You sure enough don't want that old city to see you. That man is mean as Nick. Hush. Now y'all follow me now. On over here. Over here to the skateboard. You got to be quiet now. Hush. Come on. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Oh, Jesus. Now, y'all gonna have to pardon me for a minute, because here, I've got to sit. Because I've been out there in that slave, standing out there in that cotton field, long before the sun come up. And these old bones, they just ain't what they used to be. So y'all here to find out about slavery, huh? Well, I'll tell you this. I'm the one to tell you. Because here on the plantation, work ain't never done. It's just work, 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 work all the time. Well, I'll tell you this here thing too. Now, you won't see me in your history books. I mean, not by my name, that is, but I'm all through. Now, they call us me Sam, but I don't know if that be my real name or not, because you know my mammy and my pappy, they got sold off when I was just, oh Lord, just a pup. But that's what they call me around here. Now see, on plantations, your name can be changed at any time. Because see, if there's more than one family, they can either change your name or, let me see if I can explain this. If there's more than one Sally, they can say, Sally up in the kitchen. You know Sally up there in the kitchen. No, I'm talking about Sally down there that tends the chillers. Now, how in the world would you like to be called Sally of the field? Lord, have mercy. Now see, I'd like to think though that my mammy, she gave me a name that she liked. You know, a pretty little name like maybe your mammy and your pappy that gives to you. Babe, what's your name?
Malina.
Malina. Oh, see, that means you got a name that means something. It makes you be somebody. Lord have mercy. Now, I say, what's that? Oh, you want to know about Master? Lord have mercy. That man is dumber than a rock. He that calls slaves be saved. That they be happy. Now, how is in the world anybody's going to be happy when you ain't got your freedom? It's all taken away from you. So, he says, slaves be dumb. I say, and then he come around saying big words to the slaves. He said, slaves is inferior to white folks. Lord have mercy, what is inferior to? He don't know my history. He don't know nothing about my ancestors. We be strong people. Because you sure enough got to be strong to be out here on this plantation. If there are slaves be so dumb, then why master don't know what we be saying in them their songs? That's it. He don't know. See, we used to talk to one another through the drum. But Master took that away from us. So this is what he do. We learned how to sing the messages. So we sang the songs. We sang the songs. And you know, Master, now watch it now. Watch out. So he done. He come down to the street corner. He say to us, sing me one of them old songs y'all be singing out there in the fields. See what he done now? You see what he done? He done get a slave to pass the message of hope and freedom right out of his face. He done. The slave get all the message all that day, because he done gives us the permission. Well, if you listen real close now, you might just hear the slave say one of the old slave songs, "Light Steals Away." Listen now, you'll hear. Just listen. You'll hear him saying, "Yes,
Hey, come in there. Did you know that African Americans created anything that you use every day in the street?
Yep, we sure did.
My name is Robinson. He lived in Huntsville, 1887. C.A. Carson, he invented the song on July 25th, 1876.
Yeah. But did you know that Thomas W. Stewart invented the mop, June 11, 1893?
Well, A.L. Carroll invented the ice cream soup on February 2nd, 1897.
But did you know that Dick Kennedy invented the refrigerator June 14th, 1891?
Well, overall, these are all great inventors. We pay respect to them.
The end of the American Civil Rights in 1865 inaugurated the Great Migration North, which led millions of African Americans away from racially oppressive environment. In the South, it ushered in a new era. Increased education and employment opportunities for African Americans.
Many found opportunity in Harlem during the 1920s. This neighborhood became home to some of the best and brightest minds of the 20th century and gave birth to a cultural revolution of art, fashion, and entrepreneurship. It earned its status as the capital of Black America, which also became known as Harlem Renaissance.
Some authors became nationally known. They were Zora Neale Hurston, James W. Johnson, and Winston Hughes.
Musicians Louis Armstrong, Duke Ellington, Cab Calloway, Art Tatum, and Josephine Baker. Entertainment venues like TPD's, the Apollo Theater, the Harlem Globetrotters, and the Cotton Club. Tonight we have a special guest at the Cotton Club performing Meet Girl Mother by Winston Hughes. And his private appearance by Josephine Baker. Welcome.
Children, I come back today to tell you a story of the long, dark way that I had to climb, that I had to know, in order that the race might live and grow. Look at my face, dark and light, yet shine like the sun with love's true light. I am the dark with a world I gave. Yeah.
civil rights movement in 1955 to 1968 refers to the movements of the United States aimed at outlawing racial discrimination, such as the Jim Crow laws against African Americans and restoring voting rights to them.
Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around, turn me around, turn me around. Keep on talking, marching up the freedom lane.
Lord,
He died before King for a few years. But while living, he was advised to make a leap. Going from the context to an influence over the globe. He was an activist, but also a black Muslim. Joined a group leaning towards separatism, rejecting the political process, causing him to have some early incomplete views due to the Nation of Islam's influence on his speech. Holding a certain merit, but becoming his most criticized. How can I use some slanderous name problems when he spoke about other black leaders? Makes an accusation that caused a divide between X and the movement. For Malcolm led the Nation, he was no longer restricted in view of religion, becoming what some say a true Muslim at the Mecca, but also a true activist as well. With a renewed vision, Malcolm put personal beliefs aside, delivering some of his most memorable speeches. Now, speaking on the ballot, he addressed political maturity, voting wisely, not recklessly, criticizing the voter system in general, and the government relative to acknowledge the laws and regulations that they keep themselves in place. Saying that, quote, running for the federal government to keep local government in check is like running for the group with bots. They're all in groups together. When we're talking on civil rights, he wants to elevate it to human rights. Since keeping our promise of domestic matter is asking Uncle Sam to treat you right as opposed to demanding without giving rights.
Oh.
And when speaking on self-defense, he stated that if we're coming for the bullet, it'll be the result of a misunderstanding of the ballot and what we're supposed to get from it. Truly, X was coming into complete view, believing the Nation of Islam caused threats on his life till 1965 he was assassinated. 1 year after meeting King, and 3 years prior to King's assassination. The words that Malcolm Martin left were eternal, empowering all people through a party bearing the image of a black panther. From their start, they chose to set up a 10-point program based on influential persons prior to them, solidifying their stance on principles, not color. Former of the minds of Huey P. Newton, and Bobby Seale, the party was set up by the likes of Little Bobby Hutton, joined at the age of 16. George Jackson, a political prisoner who became a member of the Huey in jail. Angela Davis, a longtime activist, and Sophie Carlisle, another political activist. Now, Sophie Carlisle initially became the honorary prime minister to the party itself. But this all started in the community's vote. And around the area. The party introduced a lot of things, but some of the main things they did was cop watches, you know, children's breakfast programs, feeding kids, community clinics, to help people, community schooling to teach people, and more, all regulated by the people. Soon they had chapters across the nation and farther. Reaching in China, Japan, Algeria, as the party believed in worldwide revolution. Huey P. Newton, by invitation, actually went to China and met Chairman Mao in person a year, 1971, before President Richard Nixon did in 1972. An example of revolutionaries at their finest. Yet, they were serving by our very own government, dismantled by saboteurs, drugs, unjust imprisonments, and murders raised by cops. Afterward, leading us to a lapse of a consciousness among all people. The movement, the revolution, was put to sleep. But my eyes opened, so I'll ask, how do we go from a blossoming prosperity to this dismal disparity in the land of life and liberty? They may have called it resistance, but I pass my motion to this world. I say if we can find recognition in ourselves again, then we can absolve the heart, maybe find something to bleed for. Now to end this with the words of the King, I quote, I submit to you that if a man has discovered something he will die for, he isn't fit to live. Thank you.
before I show you what I'm going to show you. Okay? So, check it out. In 1975, there was a brother that came to Oakland, right? And he was shot in Oakland on the streets. His name was Pule Shovel. The people didn't know who shot him. It was an accident. It was like a bystander, innocent bystander. Was that the brother was from South Africa, all right? In South Africa, 200 years ago, the Dutch traders came and stayed and built their government off the backs of the natives, the Zulu and the Bantu people in South Africa. Okay? That system of government that they created was called apartheid. Say apartheid.
Apartheid!
Okay, and that was a system where the black people were on the bottom and the white people were on the top. And it was law. It was law. And that system of government lasted until 1992. Wow. Okay? And so the whole world fought against it and ended that system. Alright? Especially the people in South Africa. If you were a black man in South Africa before 1992, and you turned 18, you lived in the townships, you were drafted. You were conscripted to work in the mines to dig gold and diamonds. Alright? You had to travel far away from your family for 6 months at a time. Okay? And live in these horrible conditions and work in these horrible conditions. Alright? This was part of the horror of South Africa's system of apartheid. Okay? Pule Shova, the man who came to Oakland, he worked in the mines. He worked in the mines. And there, they only had one day off. Sunday. And on that day, they created a competitive dance routine, you know, and with the boots that they had to wear in the mines. They called it the gum boot dance. These are gum rubber boots. They call it the boot dance. And there are many types of boot dance, but this boot dance, Pule Shova learned, he came to Oakland, he taught it to my father, and my father taught it to me. And I taught it to these young brothers from the third floor, so look at you.
Thank you.
by declaring that rightful citizens of the United States voting shall not be denied or abridged. By the United States or by any other state account on race, color, or previous consideration of servitude.
Senator Harry Ruggles of Mississippi, the first African American to serve in Congress, toured the United States in 1871, he was introduced as the 15th Amendment, flesh and blood.
Jim Crow, the exclusion of African Americans from Congress in 1887 to 1929. This era was defined by the long war on African American participation in state and federal politics, waged by means of local Southern laws. Jim Crow segregation and tactics federal assent only. A few blacks served in Congress at this time.
He even said, African Americans were here in Congress in 1997. Washington Freeze took the oath of office as a member of Congress on April 15, 1929. He became the first African American elected to that body in the 20th century and the first African American to be elected from an urban city.
The expansion, organization, and the rising influence of African Americans in Congress, 1971 to 2012. The modern year African American history in Congress, in 1971, black members enjoyed the tremendous surge in numbers as minority groups of women exercise their freedom and participation in American society.
Barack Hussein Obama, born August 4, 1961, is the 44th president and current president of the United States. He's the first American in the office. Obama previously served as the United States Senator for Illinois from January 25 until he resigned following the victory in the 2008 presidential election.
Goodbye.